This is the video lecture on depreciation and depletion. Now, depreciation is a topic that we talked about earlier when we talked about the adjusting process. But now we're going to talk about depreciation in a lot more detail in this particular lecture. Now, depreciation is a way of slowly expensing an asset. So rather than expense the asset all at once, it's a way of spreading that out over many different years. Now, what are the assets that GAAP requires us to depreciate? Well, they're pretty much going to be assets that are in one particular category, and those would be the plant assets. In fact, we're going to depreciate all of the plant assets except for one. So in that category of plant assets, it could potentially be any buildings that we own, any land improvements that have been made, equipment, machinery, and vehicles. So all of those are plant assets. They are all long-term assets that we have for many years, and they are all assets that we utilize in the business. The one plant asset that we do not depreciate is actually land, because land has an indefinite lifespan. So there would be no way to actually calculate the depreciation on land. But all the others will actually be depreciated. In fact, GAAP requires us to depreciate those assets. Now, if we're going to depreciate our assets, how are we going to do that? Well, we actually have different methods of depreciation. And there are actually many different methods, but there are three in particular that are very commonly used. And all three of these methods are appropriate and have been approved according to GAAP. So in each business, they will make a decision about what method of depreciation they want to use. And they could also potentially use multiple methods. They might use one method for certain assets and another method for other assets. So that's why it's very important for us to learn all three of these depreciation methods. And they include the straight line, units of production, and declining balance. Now, the straight line method, we actually talked about this method before in our lecture on adjustments. But this is a good time to talk about straight line again. Remember, straight line is the most commonly used. More people use this method than any other. And probably the reason is because it's so simple. It's very simple. It's very straightforward. The formula for straight line would be cost minus salvage value divided by useful life in years. And the great thing about straight line is that once you calculate that answer, you never have to recalculate it. You would book the same exact depreciation expense every single year. In fact, that's why they call it straight line depreciation. So to see this in an example, we have a business that has purchased equipment. Now, right off the bat, when we see equipment, we know that's one of the plant assets, and that's one of the ones that gets depreciated. Now, this equipment originally cost $100,000. Now, based on their expectations, based on their estimates, they believe that it will have a $10,000 salvage value and a 10-year useful lifespan. So based on that, we could calculate straight line depreciation. $100,000 minus $10,000 divided by 10 years. And that would give us an answer of $9,000. So in the first year of owning that asset, we want to take $9,000 worth of depreciation. And we've done this journal entry before. We debit depreciation expense and credit accumulated depreciation. And that account shows us a running total of all the depreciation that has accumulated on that asset. Now, if we don't want to use straight line method, we have a couple other options. We could also potentially use the units of production method. Now, we've never talked about this particular method before. This method is also fairly common, not quite as common as straight line, and this method is a little bit more complicated. In this method, units of production, we actually take into consideration the usage of the equipment. The idea is that if the equipment or the asset is used a lot, then we should probably take a lot of depreciation that year. But if the equipment isn't used very much, we should take less depreciation. So with this method, you would actually have to recalculate the depreciation every single year because it would depend upon the usage of the asset. So the formula is cost minus salvage value divided by total units of capacity. And then that answer is multiplied by the units for the period. So it's a different type of calculation. And it starts off very similar to straight line with the cost minus salvage value, but the difference there is instead of using lifespan in years, we're using a capacity, a total capacity of that asset, and then multiplied by the units for that period. So to see this in an example, fairly similar example to the last one, it is equipment. It did cost $100,000. It does have a $10,000 salvage, but the difference here is, rather than quote us a lifespan in years, we're going to have a lifespan in terms of capacity. So we're saying that the total capability or total capacity of that equipment would be to process 10,000 units. So that's like a lifespan, but it's in a capacity rather than years. And they're telling us that in the first year, they used the equipment to process 2,500 units. So based on that, we would record depreciation under this method. So we would have the cost, 100,000, minus the salvage, 10,000. We divide that by 10,000 units, and then we multiply that by 2,500, and we get an answer of $22,500. And notice, the journal entry titles are exactly the same. We debit depreciation expense, and we credit accumulated depreciation. So the journal entry titles that are used, they don't really change. The only thing that changes is the amount, and that's based on a different method. Now bear in mind, we would not do this in addition to what we did in the previous example. We would do one or the other. Remember, we have three methods. We're going to pick one of these. We're just showing you how it would be different depending on which method they select. And then there's a third possibility. We could also use declining balance method. This is yet another option, and this one is also approved by GAAP. Now this method is a little different. The formula is 1 divided by years of life times 2 times cost. So it's a totally different formula than straight line or units of production. This method will give you a much higher depreciation, at least in the first year. So again, using that same example that we've had all along, equipment, $100,000 cost, $10,000 salvage, 10-year lifespan. This time it would be 1 divided by 10 times 2 times 100,000. And we get $20,000 worth of depreciation. Again, the titles haven't changed. It's depreciation expense, accumulated depreciation. So the only thing that changes is the amount. And it's up to the business. You know, they could use any of these three methods they want. They're all approved according to GAAP. So that's why we need to know all three, because when you work with a particular company or a particular problem or example, you never know what method they're going to use, so it's good to know how to use all three.